drinks. She was amazing. Just another convention center. Just kisses her hand and a dream in her heart.
Just arrived, 17, all the way from the city of New England.
City. I am Erin Walsh and Litchfield. Connecticut's 62nd and our second year here at the beautiful Fox Theater.
It has truly been an exciting week, and we have many, many surprises in store for you this evening. And what I would like to do right now is reintroduce to you Mary Grace Santagata, our Miss Connecticut 1995, to introduce the Better Homes Foundation Award. Mary Grace.
Actually, it's my privilege to announce some people that have come in from Massachusetts from the Better Homes Fund that we have been working with, along with our scholarship winners. I'm very excited and proud to announce them to come out and give the award. Pat DeBuse.
It's a very great pleasure to be here tonight because we're doing something very special. We're giving a young woman a $10,000 scholarship. She's in the eighth grade at Sheridan Middle School in New Haven, Connecticut. And the award is given because the award was created by the Miss America organization, the Better Homes Fund, as a combined service learning project and scholarship program. And Jennifer is the first winner of the scholarship. Jennifer? This is Jennifer Hall.
Good evening. Community service has been an inspirational part of my life. I feel it is important for everyone to be involved in their community, especially young people like myself. I would like to thank the Miss America organization and the Better Homes Fund for providing the opportunity for youth to get involved in community service. I hope to be an influential part of promoting this project to other states. In this day and age of youth, gangs, and teenage pregnancies, drug abuse, and AIDS, it is an important part of our young life for our parents and other parental guidances to encourage young people to get involved in community service. which can guide us on the path to success. Thank you.
I'd like to introduce the president of the Better Homes Fund, Dr. Ellen Bassett. She will present the award to the school. Ellen?
We're delighted to be here tonight to present this first scholarship award. The Miss America organization and the Better Homes Fund commend the administration, faculty, staff, and students of the Susan B. Sheridan Middle School for their selection and enthusiastic participation in the nation's first Youth America project. Working collaboratively, they have set a standard of excellence for others to follow. Congratulations.
My name is Robert Canelli. I'm the principal at Sheridan Middle School, New Haven. I see a few of my parents out here. I want to thank the Better Homes Foundation for selecting Sheridan Middle School. We're very proud, our staff and our students, to work with such wonderful people throughout the school year. I want to especially thank Mary Grace Santagata for all her help coming to Sheridan weekly. We had the privilege of beating several of our contestants. They came to Sheridan and learned how to do double dutch and some of the other fun activities. I also want to just say that Jennifer Hall is a wonderful young woman, and she exemplifies what an eighth grader should be. She's smart, she's intelligent, she's beautiful, but also she has a certain sense of pride, and that's what makes it all beautiful. So again, I want to congratulate Jennifer and her mom and everyone on behalf of Sheridan Middle School. Thank you.
We're about to continue the exciting search for Miss Connecticut 1995. In just a few moments, we're going to find out who the judges selected as the top 10 women who can fulfill the Miss America slot, or Miss Connecticut slot, for the woman of the 90s. I don't know how the judges do it every year, Gary. I mean, I'm serious. I think these women get more and more dynamic every year.
Well, I'll tell you, we're not short of talent up here on the stage. There's no doubt about it that our contestants have just completed two very tough days of preliminary competitions. The judges have scored them in talent, in swimsuit, in evening wear, and also a 12-minute personal interview. And the topics have varied from personal goals to current events.
That's right. Now, before we reveal the top 10 finalists, I think the congratulations are in order to each of our outstanding young women who have made it here to the Miss Connecticut pageant. Whether or not their name is called tonight or not, we take pride in their accomplishments. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the next big step on the way to an incredible year of opportunity. A scholarship award of over $5,000 and the title of Miss Connecticut and the opportunity to compete in the Miss America pageant in Atlantic City in September.
You know, Michael, I am very, very nervous. I wasn't even this nervous last night when I sang. And I did get good scores, by the way. Thank you very much. Please, let go, will you end the suspense?
All right, Gary, the 1995 Miss Connecticut semi-finalists are... Contestant number one, Marine Show Miss Greta New Haven. Contestant number seven, Jennifer Nash, Miss Meriden. Contestant number 22, Jennifer Buffard, Miss Nelson Hall. Contestant number 10, Kimberly Hoffman, Miss Nelson Hall.
Either to Miss Connecticut or ends up going to Miss America. They are volunteers and they put their whole heart and soul into things. So that is why we have a ceremony like the one we had today. We did not announce the pageant of the year because we figured we'd do it in front of all of you. So I have the esteemed pleasure of announcing our pageant of the year, and that is the Miss Bristol pageant. Very hard, and a lot of my Miss Bristols are in the audience because we're a real family, Joe down here, and my good friend Gloria, who's always here to watch every Miss Bristol succeed, and my husband and I, just, this is a family thing, we've been doing it for 8 years, we've been involved in the pageant since 1982, and we hope for many more years to come. Thank you very much.
And I also want to add that we do have a very good committee also.
They're Sharon and Rick Raymond.
Tonight, you will see, once again, the swimsuit talent and evening wear competition, which will ultimately decide our new next Miss Connecticut. But first, let me introduce to you some very special guests that are with us this evening.
This past April, our producer, Louis Pavone, and the Miss Connecticut Scholarship Foundation Committee once again held their fifth annual Miss Connecticut Sweetheart Pageant to benefit the Scholarship Foundation. Now, the contest was held in Vernon, and there were over 60 young ladies competing from the ages of 5 to 16.
That's right, Mancola, and as host of that event, I'm very, very, very proud to reintroduce them this evening.
The Miss Connecticut Sweetheart Program, or pageants, are training grounds for young ladies to prepare them for tomorrow when they may eventually compete in the Miss Connecticut pageant. Although they are not an official Miss America program, they were originated by our state organization as a way of young women to get a head start in preparing them for the Miss America system and as a means of scholarship fundraising for the Miss Connecticut pageant.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, let me introduce to you Little Miss Connecticut Sweetheart 1995, Tina Fierro. Connecticut Sweetheart 1995, Ashley Bray. And
thank you, Ashley.
Oh, I think she wants to stay and compete. And Miss Connecticut Preteen and Miss Talent Connecticut, Caitlin Goss. Miss Connecticut Teen Sweetheart, Brooke Basler. Thank you, Brooke.
Now we have some other special ladies that have come here to join us this evening, and we'll also have an opportunity of seeing them in the Miss America pageant come September. They are Miss Massachusetts, Marcia Turner. Miss Massachusetts 1995. And now, please welcome Miss New Hampshire, Stephanie Boise. Miss New Hampshire 1995. Good luck to you ladies in Atlantic City. Right now we're going to meet once again a very dynamic and talented young woman. And I'm telling you one thing that I know for sure. Whoever ends up winning the title of Miss Connecticut 1995 tonight will have some awfully big shoes to fill. Please welcome back Mary Grace Santagata, your Miss Connecticut 1994. I just wonder, do you realize what an extraordinary representative you've had this year? Do you realize that? I'm not trying to make her blush for anything, but you know, I asked Mary Grace certain questions. I thought, you know, let me find out a little bit about what she's been doing this year. And you know what? She didn't really tell me everything. I found out that if I talked to other people, I got a little bit more information. There's a story that I want to tell you.
Uh-oh.
Okay.
I'm not going to tell you.
There's a story that I was told, and Mary Grace would never tell you this. That's why I'm going to tell you. She had an appearance at a soup kitchen, and she was paid for that appearance. Mary Grace gave back half of her fee, and then she encouraged one of the local banks to match her half and gave it back to the soup kitchen. This is the type of woman that represented Connecticut all of last year. That's why I said, you've got an extraordinary representative here, and she's been absolutely fabulous. Now, you have about an hour or so.
I told you you couldn't leave me tonight, and you're really doing it. You really are. Like, oh, love. You know I'm civil today.
I know. Oh, definitely. I share a dressing room, okay? I do not. I do know. You've got an hour or so left as Miss Connecticut.
What are your plans?
My plans are first to stay in touch with everybody here, because this pageant, this program is an amazing opportunity for young ladies. And I would like to help in any way that I can, especially with the new Miss Connecticut, to bring her through Miss America and have a wonderful time in life. My immediate plans are going to be to go into New York City to audition for Broadway.
Oh, she's looking for it.
Okay,
great.
Now, the young woman who's crowned this evening, would you have any advice for her? My advice to her would be to live each day like it were her last. And really put her whole heart and soul into her appearances, to do anything that she can do for this crown, because the year is not past forever. I found that out tonight. She needs to go down to Atlantic City, not thinking of becoming Miss America, but going down there to have a good time, to take the opportunity that they're giving her to experience and to meet new people. And then she needs to come back and be the best Miss Connecticut that she can be. And I am so excited to be able to crown her this evening. And there's no regrets on my part. I feel that I have really done what I set out to do this year. I'm very content and very excited to give her the same opportunity that I have. This crown needs to live in another's heart. And I'm very ready to crown somebody.
I think it's a fair question to ask. What has the Miss America program done for you?
It has given me an opportunity for scholarship. The money that I received from the Miss Connecticut Scholarship Pageant and Miss America paid off all of my undergraduate student loans. The opportunity to use my crown as a wonderful vehicle to go into different types of philanthropic events, to schools, to prisons, and to really make a mark on our state and to do community service. And I truly feel after this year that you really can't experience life to the fullest unless you give to other people.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
For those of you who are not aware, Mary Grace did a very wonderful job for you in Atlantic City. In fact, the song that she just sang, she sang it in Miss America Pageant and was awarded the Burton Parks Non-Finalist Talent Award.
She brought back to us this year, or this past year.
That's right. We talked earlier about the Miss Connecticut Sweetheart pageant. Now we would like to present the first Miss Talent Connecticut 1995. This new title was created this year as part of our fundraising efforts, and here is the first state winner. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Talent Connecticut 1995, Caitlin Gosley.
Gentlemen, here to help us celebrate the 75th anniversary of the Miss America pageant is Connecticut's own Miss America. Ladies and gentlemen, my honor to introduce to you Marion Bergeron Setzer, Miss America 1933.
America. You know, one of the things that I think you look forward to, other than the scholarship, is you look forward to receiving the crown. Tell me about your crown.
Oh, I had a great crown temporarily. It was stolen. The night that I became Miss America, you know, and transferring me from my hotel room to the suite, someone just plain took off with my crown. That was the end of that. I never had one after that. And right now I don't even have one, other than the halo that's been placed around my head.
Okay, well, you know that the Miss America organization now really stresses scholarships. I mean, I hope that's why you know that you're here, is you're helping some young woman to complete her education. So, since it's stressed scholarships now, what kind of prizes or money did you receive your year?
Well, that's a brilliant question. That was 1933. Has anyone here lived that long? 1933, kids, was depression. There wasn't any money, but there was a beautiful image. There was a Miss America image, and they wanted to project this wonderful home-type girl, the girl that fell out of the apple tree, the slender knee, that wasn't too bright. I qualified. They had no scholarship. They didn't have anything to offer other than themselves, and that's what they did back then. They offered what they had. They shared a little bit of this, a little bit of that, and that's what I got. That was my no education, no scholarship fund, nothing to look forward to. The girls have that today, have so much to look forward to. I still have a few things to look forward to. Reform school, maybe. The girls have such a great opportunity.
That's true. Now, I don't know how many of you realize this, but whoever's crowned Miss America always gets a brand new shiny car. Did you get one?
Yep. That I got. That they couldn't steal. That they could not take away from me. It was Ford Motor Company gave me a brand new Ford V8 with four doors, and on the side of it, it said Miss America 1933. I was 15 years old and couldn't even drive. And my dad was a policeman in West Haven, Connecticut. Boy, what a guy. And he came to Atlantic City, and he got in a car and drove out. I still see Dad driving away with this American on the side of the car. So I'm out the window, you know. There's no other policeman in West Haven, Connecticut at that time had a Ford V8 car.
Now, once Miss America, I think, always Miss America. Do you still work with the organization?
Definitely. I still do several benefits a year for the Boys and Girls Clubs of America. Actually, whenever my alleged talents are called on, I do an appearance, and I'm so happy to do that, so happy to be included, and so very, very proud that people like yourselves will still want to see me again and say, that's still our girl. And you know what? She's still in our world. One more thing I would like to ask, because this is the 75th anniversary of the Miss America pageant, and you are going to have a Miss Cadavia go there. And of course, we know that she's going to be a winner. But I would like to have just a rousing cheer that will say, Happy 75th anniversary, Miss America. So on three, would you guys yell it for me? Happy anniversary, 75th for Miss America. One, two, three, happy anniversary, Miss America.
Thank you. Miss America, Connecticut Home, Miss America, 1933. We can learn a lot from her, can't we?
She's one dynamic individual.
Oh, yes, she is. Mm-hmm.
22 exceptional young women came
here this week, vying for the title of Miss Connecticut, and we are now down to the final 10. We are proud to introduce the distinguished panel of men and women who will select our next state representative to the Miss America pageants.
Oh boy.
What are you guys going to do tonight?
William J. Haggerty is the superintendent of schools for the Quabaug Regional School District in Warren and West Brookville, Massachusetts. Bill began his association with the Miss America program as a college pageant director. He served as co-executive director and producer of the Miss New Hampshire Scholarship Program for 19 years and currently represents the Eastern Region as a member of the Board of Trustees of the National Association of the Miss America State Pageants. Please welcome William J. Haggerty.
Our next judge, Brenda F. Drake, a resident of Lewis, Delaware. Brenda is employed by Beebe Medical Center as an administrative assistant to the manager of the surgical services department of the hospital. She is also joint owner and operator of R.D. Drake Company, a general contracting firm. Brenda's 10-year affiliation with the Miss America Scholarship Pageant Program has seen her serve in such varied capacities as official traveling companion to 6 Miss Delawares, to the president of the board of directors of the Miss Delaware Scholarship Organization. Ladies and gentlemen, Brenda F.
For 20 years with the Miss America organization, serving on local, state, and national levels. A past president of the Association of Pennsylvania Scholarship Pageants, he's been a member of 20 judges panels that have selected state representatives from across the country. Jay, who is president of his family-owned funeral home, resides in Whitehall, Pennsylvania. Please welcome Jay Gilbert.
Next judge, Victoria J. Boyer. Victoria J. Boyer has owned her own dance studio in Miamisburg, Ohio, for the past 36 years. She has taught on the faculty of every leading dance organization across the country and is currently first vice president of Dance Masters of Ohio. Victoria, who has done TV commercials and professional modeling, has judged a number of preliminary pageants and state pageants from Oklahoma to Massachusetts. Victoria J. Boyer.
William Smith. Bill has done TV and print work internationally as a model, is owner and president of Vacation Hawaii Incorporated in Honolulu, Hawaii. A former singer-dancer with the Young Ambassadors, he's brought his expertise as a judge to a number of preliminary state and national pageants throughout the United States. Bill is executive director for the Miss Vacations Hawaii Scholarship Pageant, a preliminary to the Miss Hawaii Miss America Pageant. Please welcome Bill Smith.
For this year are Karen Castini, a professor of accounting at Sacred Heart University, and Darlene Gilad of Citizens Bank. Our judge's chair, thank you. Our judge's chair is Maria Druin of the Miss Connecticut Board of Directors and her committee, Dr. Philip Pelosi and Dr. Lynn Rising and Ms. Bonnie Rogers.
Meet once again in swimsuit, talent, and evening wear. Now, earlier this week, our contestants had a 12-minute private interview with the judges. Now, that interview will carry over to tonight and will count for 30% of the score. Talent will make up 40%. Evening wear and swimsuit are weighted at 15% each, with the high and the low scores discarded on all levels of competition. The judges will score each contestant on a scale of 1 to 10 in each phase of competition. Our cast of talented contestants, dancers, and Miss Connecticut 1994, Mary Grace Santagata, will take you to a tropical paradise of sun, sand, and surf. Ay, caramba!
Yeah.
You know what? On Thursday and Friday, I told them a little secret, and I think it's only fair that I share my little secret with tonight's audience. Shh, don't tell anybody. I don't want the contestants to know. But I told the group on Thursday and Friday, the ladies get a little nervous up here sometimes. To help to kind of like calm them down, I'd like to ask you all to do me a real big favor. Every time they come out on stage, scream, holler, clap your hands, go crazy, go wild, because it really helps them to do better. If you're giving them love and support, believe me, they'll give you more back and they won't be so nervous. So will you do that for me? Show me what you're going to do for me. Okay, now we're ready for our first competition for the semifinalist group. Judges will be scoring on overall first impression plus looking for a statement of physical fitness. Let's begin. With contestant number one, Maureen Show, Miss Greater New Haven.
Thank you, contestant number number 16, Miss Southington. And now, contestant number 21, Deborah Malik, Miss Greater.
Connecticut program that We could be sitting here all night just thanking people, but there are two people that I would like to recognize for their unselfish contributions to the program. Besides running a very successful business, they have literally put in thousands of hours making this whole thing happen. Ladies and gentlemen, if you would please extend a warm hand to Stan Boyes, Executive Director, and Mr. Louis LeBar, the Executive Producer. The talent competition of Miss Connecticut and Miss America is what sets this whole program apart from all the others in the country.
That's true, Gary. And you know, the Miss America stage has really been a launching pad for so many careers. I mean, you can see former contestants on daytime dramas, prime time, news. In fact, Vanessa Williams just completed her stint on Broadway in Kiss of the Spider Woman. She has a new album out called Sweetest Days, and she can also be heard on the new soundtrack for Pocahontas. From the soundtrack of Pocahontas singing the solo there. So it's been a launching pad for many young women.
It's a wonderful opportunity. The whole program, scholarship, the ability to, or the opportunity to perform, it's just absolutely wonderful. And let's not forget that it all starts on stages just like this all across the country.
Now let's see who just might be next. In this phase, judges will be looking for each contestant's interpretive ability, her preparedness, technical skill, and also stage presence. The talent score will be 40% of a total.
Let's begin. Contestant number one, Ms. Greater New Haven, Maureen Scholl. Greater New Haven perform her spirited rendition of two old favorites, Alexander's Ragtime Band, and Here's to the Band. Self-written
self-written monologue, Miss Meredith will perform The Last Time.
I'm tired of coming to see you. Why can't you come to see me? If wishes came true, you'd be knocking at my door. I still don't understand why you left that night to go to the store. After the prom, we agreed to stay in one place. We were worried about you. The store is only 5 minutes away. Half an hour goes by. In an hour, I get this phone call, you know. It's your mom. And she's crying. And I asked her what was wrong. And at first, what I thought I heard her say was a mistake. It couldn't be! It just couldn't be! But the party felt empty. And I knew. You had been in an accident. And I remember saying, he's okay, right? He's gonna be okay. But the only thing they could say was no. Why? What good is it to happen like this? Why couldn't I see you? And touch you. But now I know that this will never be. For the last time.
Musical Sunset Boulevard, Miss Mountain Laurel will now capture your heart with one poem.
With one look, I play. contestant number 11.
And now, contestant number 10, Miss North Haven, Kimberly Bowman. Miss North Haven, Kimberly Bowman, invites you to enjoy a top draw, first rate, baton twirling routine to If My Friends Could See Me Now.
If they could see me now, every word
12 Miss Nutmeg, Heather Erin Valente. Images of a pearl-white moon rising into a star-filled night, they drift to us on delicate streams of the harp as Moonrise is performed by Miss Nutmeg, Heather Erin Valente.
I'm gonna
contestant number 21 is Miss Greater New Britain, Deborah Malik. From the hit 70s movie, The Main Event, Miss Greater New Britain will sing the main event, Fight.
What?
competition is contestant number 18, Mr. London County, Satan Rose.
Guaranteed to
would like to extend a special thanks to Cindy Brown of the Foxwoods Employment Services. Cindy took care of planning all the activities for the contestants this week, so a special thanks goes out to Cindy.
And also the Miss Connecticut Board of Directors would like to take the time to thank the Foxwoods Resort and Casino and their staff once again for hosting the Miss Connecticut Scholarship Pageant. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts. Also, we'd like to also thank the Mashantucket Tribal Council for your generosity. Michael Brown, who is better known as Mickey, for just believing in this program. Thanks, Mickey.
And we'd like also to send out a special thanks to Paul Jones of the Norwich Ramada Hotel for the great job he did with the contestants earlier this week. They stayed at the Ramada Hotel. And also to the staff of Traditions of Norwich who dressed our dancers this evening.
We'd like to recognize the fact that the choreographer for this pageant has been Gloria Jean, and we want to thank her for her terrific dancers. Thank you, Gloria Jean. And our producer would also like to thank Roseanne Little and Melody Martin for the hours of work that they've done here this year. Thank you so much for attending to every detail.
Well done, friends. Now your turn.
It's my turn.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct pleasure to introduce to you again Nicola Sullivan as she performs the song that she presented in Atlantic City back in 1980. Nicola Sullivan.
Thank you.
job.
All right. Well, our final phase of competition is evening gown. And our semifinalists will be judged on overall first impression, intelligence, emotional control, their ability to communicate their poise and confidence. They will also respond to a question that's been based on their platform. So we begin now with our first contestant. Contestant number one, Maureen Schoen. Ms. Slater, move on. Maureen, what are the prospects that we may be able to ensure children will never again experience the ravages of cystic fibrosis?
Well, Nicola, 60,000 children and young adults are afflicted with that disease, and one of them is my cousin Michael. And I hope that through the great strides that they're making in the research, such as gene therapy and genetic therapy, that we can combat this disease and find a cure.
Thank you. Enforcement of drunk driving laws is sufficient enough to deter intoxicated drivers from Connecticut's highways?
I absolutely think that the laws are not strict enough, and I'll tell you why. There are many people that will get a DWI, and in 3 months, they will have their license back, and even sometimes get off. As long as they have a lawyer that will help them get off, they will. And it happens many times, and we see many unfortunate accidents because of constant offenders. My personal feeling is that they should have their license taken away for life, because that is a person's life that they are putting at stake. And it would be such a loss that this family or friend would have to suffer. It's so unfair.
To inspire the youth of Connecticut to get involved and make a difference in the lives of senior citizens.
I would absolutely show the youth that our elders are people just like us. They have many qualities that are similar. They are at a time in their lives where they are very vulnerable and need guidance, support, and love, and they need each other. Thank you.
Positive and constructive manner.
As Miss Connecticut, I would start a program called, as Miss Connecticut, I would continue working with CARE, children actively reaching out to the elderly. This program that I have started, it meets once every month with young children and senior citizens, and I feel that in getting involved with the senior citizens and young children will benefit the community and feel and see how important the senior citizens are. Thank you.
Legislature to stiffen the laws against firearms?
Well, first of all, we have to take into account the statistics. Every 20 seconds, a gun is manufactured in this country. And in 1991, those guns killed 37,000 Americans. I know because I had one tragedy happen in my life already. You see, I need to make every American understand that guns, yes, we do have the responsibility to own and possess a gun, but we also need to balance that with the responsibility. Thank you.
Operation Smile repairs devastating facial deformities in children worldwide. Many of these children aren't even given a chance to live, and many are killed at birth. Our future generation is what we should take into our hands and give a better chance at a wonderful life.
Struggle with every day, and actually it's a catch-22. You just hope you're always doing the right thing at the right time.
They can be held liable. Therefore, if I do suspect child abuse, I would not think twice. I would definitely report that.
Amy Simone, Miss Wolf. Amy, what benefit can children derive from their involvement with dance?
I believe that children can gain so much from the art of dance. It not only gains their self-esteem, their self-confidence, but it also opens their mind up to a world of creativity and imagination. What?
Does it take to become a successful mentor?
I find myself being a very influential figure in a child's life. I work at an area middle school with a young boy, and the best quality is patience and perseverance. And if I stick to that, I know that I will be a great mentor, and I know that each person out there that would like to become a mentor should have those qualities.
Sure.
we will be announcing the new Miss Connecticut 1995. But, before we do that, we have one more production number for you. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our cast as they perform Heavenly Night on the Town.
Representing the beautiful state of Connecticut and making a difference by giving of myself to others. The journey of Miss Connecticut brought me to prisons, schools, philanthropic events, and senior citizen facilities, each leaving me with a more understanding and grateful heart. Though I met many whose path I may never cross again, the gentle touch of their hearts will continue to inspire the thought that to love and minister with compassion is to see the face of God. To the Miss Connecticut Board of Directors, your unending guidance, support, and volunteerism has made my year as Miss Connecticut much more meaningful. I couldn't have done it without you. To Billy and Sue, from the very beginning, your confidence and love have always given me strength and belief in myself. You are two very selfless people. Thank you for treating me as another daughter. To Suzanne and Tony, from the very moment of my Miss Connecticut journey, you have both held my hands and helped me through each endeavor. Suzanne, you were my partner in Atlantic City, sharing each wonderful day and creating memories I will never forget. Tony, I can't imagine spending more time with anyone in 1 year, not even my husband. You have been truly wonderful this year. Thank you for your dedication, your sense of humor, and your eternal friendship. To my family and friends, you add beauty and meaning to my life. You are truly the soul of my song. In my life, I have been blessed with two exceptional parents who have given me the gift of life and the support to take on the greatest of obstacles. Mom and Dad, there has never been a moment in my life when I felt alone. Though sometimes the stage seemed bare, there were always two last people left in the audience. Always know that you are the most important people in my life and the greatest masterpiece given to me by God. And now as I wear the Miss Connecticut crown for the very last time, may I always remember the opportunity given to me and someday pass on to my daughter the wisdom expressed in the words of a senior citizen I met in a convalescent home. Though we travel the world over to find the beautiful, we must carry it with us or we find it not.
Our Miss Connecticut Scholarship Program is a part of. The Miss America organization heads 50 state pageants and over 1,400 locals across America. Throughout the Miss America system, as I mentioned earlier, they award over $24 million. Throughout the Miss America, that makes us part of the largest scholarship foundation in the world for young women. Also, your program book tonight will tell you that many of the grants, many other grants and awards our winners will receive. And when our winner goes on to compete in the Miss America pageants in Atlantic City, September the 16th, mark that on your calendars, thousands more dollars in scholarship will be available to her. If she wins the national title, let's just say even if she doesn't become Miss America, she can go on to further her education with many tuition breaks, grants, and fee courses that will be at her fingertips.
Now we've seen lots and lots of talent tonight. And, well, I don't know about you folks, but I think it's just about time. Have you picked a winner yet? They're all winners, aren't they? Give them a nice round of applause. Thanks, sir. It appears that our auditors have reached a decision. Let me see what we can do.
But first, let's reintroduce our top 10 semifinalists. Contestant number one, Maureen Show, Miss Greater New Haven. Contestant number seven, Jennifer Nash, Miss Marion. Contestant number 22, Jennifer Superbar, Miss Mountain Laurel. Contestant number 10, Kimberly Bowman, Miss North Haven. Contestant number 12, Heather Erin Valenti, Miss Bethlehem. Contestant number 16, Elizabeth Sedol, Miss Southington. Contestant number 21, Deborah Malik, Miss Greater New Britain. Contestant number 19, Amy Cabal, Miss Wilson. And contestant number parole, Ms. New London County. It appears that we have a decision.
Before we do this, we're going to do this. What I'd like to do first is to introduce the Community Service Award. Open up this envelope. They certainly sealed it well. The Community Service Award goes to contestant number 18, Mr. London County.
And the Hayden C. Vandenberg Congeniality Award goes to... Chris is the phone, Ms. Rayna Watson.
And the private interviewer award goes to Elizabeth Chadone. The fourth runner-up and the winner of a $500 scholarship is contestant number 7, Jennifer Nash, Miss Meredith. $750 scholarship is contestant number 12, Heather Melendez. The second runner-up and the winner of a $1,000 scholarship, contestant number 1, Maureen Shows. And the winner of a $2,000 scholarship. And if the winner should for any reason be unable to fulfill her obligation as Miss Connecticut, will assume the title Miss Connecticut 1995. The first runner-up is contestant number 18, Stacy Barone. Coming up on stage, there will be press up here and we just need a little bit of time. Let us continue. One of these women will be your new Miss Connecticut 1995. She will not only receive a scholarship and awards valued at $22,000, but will assume the responsibility of a role model and leader in the state of Connecticut. She has an amazing year ahead of her as she travels to Atlantic City to represent the state of Connecticut in September at the Miss America pageant. Ladies and gentlemen.